Seconded by the Attorney General.
Out of the 341 MPs that attended today's session, both physically and virtually, 340 voted in favor, except for West Budama MP Fox Odoi. He not only voted against the bill, but also authored a minority report.
As returned by His Excellency the President, in accordance to Article 913B of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, and Rule 143 of the Rules of Procedure, be considered by this August House. Those in favor will say aye, and those against will say nay.
The legal committee report put into consideration part of President Museveni's reservations on the bill by amending clause 2 and 3 to create further clarity on purpose and intention of the bill to criminalize sexual acts committed by persons of the same sex, rather than punishing a person based on their perceived sexuality or physical appearance.
Honorable Speaker, the Secretary Committee on Legal and Parliamentary Affairs has examined the matters returned by the President and is ready to report on the same. Honorable Speaker, I beg to submit in support of the motion.
Distinguishing between being a homosexual and actually engaging in acts of homosexuality, this is at page 3. The first reservation by HE the President relates to the lack of clear provisions in the bill prohibiting the criminalization of individuals who have not committed any of the prohibited acts under the bill. The President argues that the law should be clear so that what is being criminalized is not the state of one having a deviant tendency, but rather the actions of one acting on the deviance or promoting the same.
To the extent that it saves the criminalization of consensual same-sex relations in clause 2 is self-defeating, since on the one hand it recognizes their existence and on the other it punishes their acts. Like the bill, the proposal by the President will still leave room for abuse of rights and freedoms of LGBTI plus community.
Parliament also made some reforms in clause 14 to limit criminal sanctions against persons who do not report acts of homosexuality that are committed against children and vulnerable people, instead of generally homosexuality acts as the original bill provided.
Clause 14 presents constitutional challenges. The President reasoned that clause 14 and 15 create unnecessary contradictions and duties which pose implementation challenges and conflicts in society. The President recommended for deletion of clause 14, or in the alternative to redraft clause 14 to restrict it to children and other vulnerable members of society.
We thank you very much. The bill, once the bill is passed into law, it's the duty of the executive to execute it, and we shall do our part as the executive. Thank you very much, Right Honourable Speaker.
However, Parliament disagrees with the President on Clause 9, which seeks to penalise persons who hire out their premises for homosexuality acts and maintain it is in the bill. Now, persons who knowingly allow their premises to be used for acts of homosexuality face 7 years in jail upon conviction, while those who fail to report acts of homosexuality while having knowledge about them face a fine of 10 million shillings or 5 years in jail.
I want to state categorically clear here, and I want to appeal to all of you here, that we should not accept the intimidation which is coming from the Western world to us as a country. The suggestion of rehabilitation is another bet that we need to look at. If you put an institution to rehabilitate in the law, it will mean that this institution cannot run dry.
That is not part of the bill.
The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, vowed that no amount of intimidation will make members of Parliament back off the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023.
Today, the 11th Parliament has gone again in the history of the books of Uganda, in the world, in Africa, and clearly brought the issue of homosexuality, the moral question that we talk about every day, the future of our children, protecting families.
MPs believe they have made the right decision by criminalizing acts of homosexuality and called upon the President to move quickly to assent to the bill.
Some people in government
are afraid, right Honourable Speaker, of the flow of resources. Can I tell you, rest your fears. Fight the corruption, we have enough money here.
From the top, but not from down.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.